There are two alternatives to connect VLANs over multiple switches. These are using a special link for each VLAN. This is not an efficient way to do this. The second way is using one trunk link that carries all these VLANs. In virtual LANs, we use this second technique. So, when we set VLAN at one end, how does the other end know this frame's VLAN? Here, the sender tags frames before sending over the trunk. The receiver checks this tag and learns the destination VLAN. By the way, the frames in access ports does not tagged. If a trunk receives an untagged frame, this means that it is coming from the native VLAN. So native VLANs must match at both ends on trunk links. What is native VLAN? We have also explained native VLAN in the VLAN part 1 video, but here let's remember, native VLAN is the VLAN for untagged frames. The default native VLAN is VLAN 1. We can change default native VLAN, and it is a good configuration habit because of security. VLAN tagging protocol .1q supports native VLAN, but ISL does not support it. There are two trunking protocols, ISL inter-switch link and IEEE 802.1q.1q. ISL inter-switch link is a Cisco proprietary old protocol. It adds 26 bytes header and 4 bytes trailer to the frame. So it increases the frame size and it causes giant frames. ISL supports 1000 VLANs on a trunk. Today, it is not used too much because recent devices do not support this protocol. How to configure ISL on Cisco switches? To configure ISL on a Cisco switch, we should use switch port trunk encapsulation SL command on the trunk interface. Standard based trunking protocol is .1q. It is developed by IEEE and it can be used by all vendors. .1q also modifies layer 2 header by adding 4 bytes VLAN tag. It supports up to 4096 VLANs on a trunk. .1q support native VLAN. Here are the parts of VLAN tag. Here, TPID is always 0x8100. This means that it is .1q tagged. PCP is used for traffic prioritization, class of service. DIE shows the first droppable traffic, even if there is a congestion. VID identifies our VLAN number. To configure .1q, we use switch port trunk encapsulation .1q command. Why we use .1q as a standard today? Because normal size of a frame is 1,514 bytes. When we use ISL, it adds 30 bytes more and creates giants. It was supported by Cisco, but other vendor devices was not support this. .1q adds 4 bytes to the frame and creates 1,518 bytes frames. This value is standard for all the vendors in the world. What about VLAN ranges? Let's remember these ranges and learn where does it come from. VID field is 12 bits long. And 2 to the 12, it can create 4,096 total VLANs on a trunk. 0 and 4,095 VLANs are reserved. From 1 to 4,094 VLANs are usable VLANs. VLAN 1 is the default VLAN. VLAN 2 to VLAN 1001 are normal VLANs. 1002 to 1005 are FDDI and token ring VLANs. And lastly, 1006 to 4094 are extended VLANs. By the way, old switches does not support extended VLAN ranges. Trunking can be statically or dynamically in VLANs. The static way is manual trunk configuration. The dynamic way is DTP, dynamic trunking protocol. It is used to negotiate forming a trunk between two Cisco devices. DTP is a Cisco proprietary protocol. It determines the status of the interface dynamically. By default, DTP is enabled on Cisco switches. For network security, it is good to disable DTP and use manual trunk configuration. What about DTP modes? There are different DTP trunking modes. These are access, trunk, dynamic auto, dynamic desirable, non-negotiate. Access mode puts interface into permanent non-trunking mode. This is used on access ports. To configure access mode, we use switch port mode access command. Trunk mode puts ports into permanent trunk mode. We use this for manual trunk configuration. To configure it, we use switch port mode trunk command. Dynamic auto is the passive mode of DTP. It does not actively attempt to build trunk. Instead of this, it waits the other end. This is the default mode of the recent switches. To configure an interface with dynamic auto, we use switch port mode dynamic auto command. Dynamic desirable is the active mode of DTP. It actively converts the link to a trunk. This is the default mode for the old switches. To configure dynamic desirable, we use switch port mode dynamic desirable command. The last one is non-negotiate. It is used to disable DTP. Non-negotiate prevents sending DTP frames. We use switch port non-negotiate command to configure a port as non-negotiate. Here are some visuals that will show you the result of two different DTP modes. When we use dynamic desirable on both ends, the link becomes a trunk. If one end is dynamic desirable and the other one is dynamic auto, again trunk is built. If one end is configured with dynamic desirable and the other end has manual config, it is also trunk. This is also true for dynamic auto and manual trunk configurations. But when we use dynamic desirable with a manual access mode config, the link is not become a trunk. This is also true for dynamic auto to manual access mode configuration. If we configure both end as dynamic auto, it will not create trunk link again. Here is a small table of these DTP modes and their results. You can check this DTP table to see if your modes serrates a trunk or not. DTP is also used for encapsulation negotiation. In other words, to determine the used trunking protocol, ISL or .1Q. Here, if there are two different configs, ISL is favored. It is enabled by default. To configure encapsulation negotiation, we use switch port trunk encapsulation negotiate command. By the way, DTP frames are sent over VLAN 1 for ISL. For .1Q, DTP frames are sent over native VLAN. This is end of our lesson. Now, it is time to test what you have learned. Question 1. Which one is not true for native VLAN? .1Q supports native VLAN. VLAN for untagged frames configured under trunk interface can be different in both ends. And default native VLAN is VLAN 1. Our answer is D, because native VLAN configuration must match at both ends of the trunk. Question 2. Which one is a standard-based VLAN tagging protocol? DTP, LLDP, ISL, .1Q, or VTP? Our answer is D, .1Q. Question 3. How many bytes are added to the frame with 802.1Q? 1, 2, 4, 8, or 16? Our answer is C4 bytes. Question 4. Which one is the extended VLAN range? 1-1005, 0-1000, 1000-4000, 1-4094, or 1006-4094? Our answer is 1006-4094. How many VLANs are supported in an 802.1Q trunk? 1005, 4096, 1000, 2048, or 100? Let's remember 12 VID bits. 2 to the 12 is equal to 4096. Our answer is B. Question 6. Which DTP trunking mode pairs do not establish trunk? Dynamic auto, dynamic auto, dynamic desirable, dynamic auto, dynamic auto, dynamic desirable, dynamic desirable, dynamic desirable, all of them. If both ends are configured as dynamic auto, this link do not become a trunk link. Question 7. How many bits are there in a VID field which identifies VLAN number? 4, 8, 12, 16, or 32? There are 12 bits in VID field, so our answer is C. This is end of our lesson, guys. If you like this video, please do not forget to like it and do not forget to share it with your friends. We are also waiting for your subscription. Without you, we are missing. With you, we are complete. Good luck!